this video, we will speak about a new drug, ARNI, angiotensin 2 receptor blockers, neprilysin inhibitors. ARNI is a new drug class that is used mainly for the treatment of heart failure with reduced ejection fraction. This drug class includes a combination of sacubitril and valsartan. Sacubitril inhibits the enzyme neprilysin, which is responsible for degradation of the natriuretic peptides. This leads to an increase in the serum natriuretic peptides level. Natriuretic peptides have multiple effects directed mainly on the reduction of blood pressure and a decrease in the pre- and afterload. First of all, natriuretic peptides reduce the reabsorption of sodium and fluid in the kidneys. Also, these peptides result in the dilation of afferent glomerular arterioles, constriction of the afferent glomerular arterioles leading to the increase in glomerular filtration rate. Natriuretic peptides inhibit the secretion of renin, resulting in the prevention of activation of the renin-angiotensin-aldosterone system. This leads to the reduction of aldosterone secretion. Aldosterone causes the reabsorption of sodium and water into the blood and secretion of potassium into the urine. Natriuretic peptides relax vascular smooth muscles in the arterioles and venules, prevent the ventricular hypertrophy. Natriuretic peptides are degraded under the influence of a neutral endopeptidase, neprilysin. Sacubitril increases serum level of natriuretic peptides by the inhibition of neprilysin. But if sacubitril is used without additional inhibition of renin-angiotensin-aldosterone system, the excessive aldosterone is secreted. For its prevention, sacubitril is combined with valsartan. Valsartan is angiotensin II receptor blockers. In order to better understand the mechanism of its action, we will talk about renin-angiotensin-aldosterone system. Juxtaglomerular cells release renin in response to a decrease in afferent arterial pressure. Reduce sodium chloride delivery to macula densa and increase sympathetic tone. Renin cleaves a decapeptide angiotensin 1 from angiotensinogen. Angiotensin 1 is transformed in angiotensin 2 by the angiotensin converting enzyme, also called ACE, which is synthesized mainly in the lungs. Angiotensin 2 is the strongest vasoconstructive factor. Besides direct vasoconstructive effect, it causes aldosterone release in the adrenal cortex leading to the sodium and fluid retention and potassium excretion and impaired endothelial cell function. Also, angiotensin II causes the release of vasopressin, exhibiting reabsorption of water in the kidneys, and it has vasoconstructive effects. Also, vasopressin enhances the sensation of thirst. Angiotensin II stimulates sodium-hydrogen exchangers, increasing a sodium reabsorption. All these mechanisms lead to an increase in both blood volume and vascular tone, resulting in elevated blood pressure. Also, this results in increased afterload. Afterload is the pressure against which the heart pumps the blood through the ventricular systole. If afterload is raised, the ventricle must create a higher tension to eject the same volume of blood compared to the normal heart. Valsartan, inhibiting angiotensin II receptor blockers, prevents undesirable effects of angiotensin II. Thus, it has the vasodilating properties, prevents an excessive aldosterone secretion, reducing sodium and fluid retention. And also, it reduces the pre- and afterload. Why should sacubitril be not combined with angiotensin-converting enzyme inhibitors? Besides the natriuretic peptides, bradykinin is degraded by the neprilysin as well. Angiotensin-converting enzyme breaks down the bradykinin too. So both sacubitril and angiotensin-converting enzyme inhibitors cause the increase in bradykinin level, and their combination creates the concentration of bradykinin too high, and side effects of an excessive amount of the bradykinin develops. This is associated with angioedema. That is significantly rare if the combination of sacubitril valsartan is used. Hyperkalemia is a frequent side effect of the use of sacubitril valsartan. Both sacubitril and valsartan causes increased serum potassium. Also, hypotension can occur. It results from reduced serum aldosterone level, blockade of angiotensin II receptors, increased diuresis, reduced sodium level, elevated potassium level. Other side effects include increased serum creatinine, dizziness, renal failure, cough, decreased hematocrit, orthostatic hypotension. Renal function may be deteriorated, particularly in patients whose glomerular filtration rate is dependent on efferent arterial vasoconstriction by angiotensin II. Small elevation of serum creatinine often occurs at the initiation of therapy. And the drug should be discontinued in patients with significant and progressive impairment of renal function. This drug is not prescribed during pregnancy and in case of pregnancy should be discontinued as soon as possible. There are two brand names of sacubitril-valsartan combination, Entresto and Uperio. These drugs are taken twice a day. There are following doses: 24, 26, 49, 51, 97, 103 mg. The dose should be uptitrated to the dose of 97, 103 mg twice a day if patient tolerates. If patient previously has taken low dose of ACE inhibitors or angiotensin receptor blockers or hasn't taken them at all, initial dose is 24, 26 mg. If patient previously has taken a moderate or high dose of ACE inhibitors or angiotensin receptor blockers, the initial dose is 49, 51 mg twice a day. For patients with reduced glomerular filtration rate and hepatic impairment, this drug should be prescribed carefully, and the dose should not be high. Sacubitril-valsartan combination should not be combined with ACE inhibitors and renin inhibitors. ARNI reduces morbidity, hospitalization rate, cardiovascular death, and all-cause mortality. According to 2016 European Society of Cardiology guidelines for the diagnosis and treatment of acute and chronic heart failure, ARNI is recommended when the patient remains symptomatic and the ejection fraction is lower than 35%, despite the treatment with beta blockers, ACE inhibitors, or angiotensin II receptor blockers and mineralocorticoid receptors antagonists. Thanks for watching this video. Please comment, subscribe, and hit the like button.